Hello, everyone. Welcome to Angel Healing House Radio. My name is Claire Candy Hoff. Through my business, Angel Healing House, which can be found at angelhealinghouse.com. I'm a writer and an author, an international radio host, a Reiki master teacher, and an angel practitioner. My inspirational books entitled Angels of Faith and One True Home Behind the Veil of Forgetfulness, and my autobiography, I Am an Angelic Walk-In, are based on my recollections of our life in spirit, and they help us to remember our divine, eternal natures. Through Angel Healing House, I help people to let go of sadness, anger, bitterness, resentment, and regret that has kept them locked in the prison of the past, and I help them to let go of worry, stress, and control, which has kept them focused on an imagined future. And once they are no longer living in the past or the future, they can start to live in the present moment, which is the only place that they can experience synchronicities, miracles, and magic. As an angel practitioner, I help people to see their lives from a higher perspective with the help of an extraordinary group of angels who call themselves the Posse of Angels. Just like my angelic family, the Posse of Angels, I'm very excited to take some of your calls for that free angel advice. You can call into the show on 1-800-930-2819. But before we get to those callers, welcome everyone to Angel Healing House Radio. Before we begin today's show, I want to remind everyone that there is a powerful full moon this week on Thursday, June 28th, and it's actually preparing us for the eclipses that are coming next month in July. Now, on July 13th, there is a partial solar eclipse, and on July 27th, there is a lunar eclipse. The full moon on the 28th actually falls in the sign of Capricorn. Capricorn, the goat. Keywords for this full moon are grounded, stable, determined, and hardworking. This reliable and focus-driven energy will help us to stay strong and resolute in our convictions and able to deal with changes which will be brought about and revealed by these eclipses. Whatever that Capricorn goat puts in his mind to do, he will succeed at with his tenacity, his will, determination, and also his belief in himself. And this energy is also fostering our belief in ourselves. The energy of the Capricorn moon is encouraging us to push past anything that may be stopping us or holding us back, and to find the courage to pursue our dreams and to be true to who we are. Now, on to today's topic, which is a little bit more somber than some of the other topics, but it is very timely. With the tragic news about the suicides of Kate Spade and Anthony Bourdain, the Posse of Angels wish to address the subject of suicide in today's program, which they've entitled Suicide from an Angel's Perspective. Now, it is very distressing to see two celebrated people of notoriety in their chosen fields taking their lives. And while the reasons for someone to ultimately choose to suicide are probably as different as the individuals themselves, the Posse of Angels wishes to address not the reason, but more so the consequences of what happens across the veil of someone choosing to take just such an action. Now, the Posse of Angels wishes to remind all of us that before we incarnate in human form, each one of us, each soul, writes the contract for their life and chooses many other souls to play different roles. In essence, these souls are to be actors in the theater of our life. And while some of these souls play major parts, like our parents, our siblings, our spouses, there are countless other souls who play minor yet very important roles. And while one life may seem to be small, it involves the weaving and the intertwining of people's lives to help each other to grow, to be challenged, to expand, and ultimately to experience life. And with each soul carefully and very thoughtfully planning out just how long they will need for in each incarnation before they cross over, they carefully contract the perfectly timed exit plan. Now, this exit plan, or when a person crosses over, allows for and brings to completion all the interplaying and interaction that each one of those souls needed for their mutual growth and soul's experience. In effect, a soul is responsible for the important part they play in another person's life, as no connections are random. With these connections being so well thought out and divinely timed to perfection, it is incredible to see when the Posse of Angels are reminding us that when one chooses, for whatever reason, to suicide and end their contract, they leave huge gaping holes as the role that they contracted to fulfill in another person's life is no longer going to be fulfilled by them. Just imagine hundreds or thousands of people who were expecting a person to provide some timely and significant information of guidance, direction, encouragement, perhaps hope and support for the formation of their contract and the learning of their lessons, and with their exit, this never happens. And while one would think that the responsibility to these other chosen souls in one's contract ends with the crossing over of their physical body, when one chooses to take their life, they are still very much responsible for leaving people in the lurch and fulfilling those gaping holes and fixing them from across the veil. Now, just imagine having made all of these contracts with all of these other souls, and we choose to take our life. There'll be no prearranged meetings to give others important information that we contracted to impart to them on how they can proceed with their lives. Perhaps this information will tie up and will cleanse us and clear us of our karma. Those seemingly random and synchronistic meetings that hold vital clues for others will never, ever show up. With these hundreds, sometimes thousands of souls who are very much dependent upon us being their compass, and on the flip side, our contract would have allowed those chosen souls to play the role of a compass. And when one suddenly suicides and leaves many souls hanging, it is an absolute nightmare. Now, the Posse of Angels is telling us that when this occurs, spirit guides, angels, and the Etheric Council, they will all provide help for us to rectify this immense redirection of events. But ultimately, it's ours to deal with and make it right from the other side. Now, having taken a look at what happens when we alter the contract for our present incarnation, the Posse of Angels wishes to show us a glimpse of what happens when we cross over after taking our life. Many who end their lives through suicide have allowed such negative beliefs to saturate their souls, saturate their being, that when they pass over, the pain does not automatically end just because they are no longer in their physical body. Afterward, the soul may find that they are in a state of gut-wrenching guilt and terrible shame, which are two of the lowest forms of energy that one can have. Now, these energies are such a heavy burden to the soul that they are often consumed with the fear of facing judgment for what they have done, when, in actual fact, the Posse of Angels wish to remind all of us that there is no judgment across the veil. But the darkness perpetuated by the lower frequencies of their negative emotions can actually stop souls from fully crossing over, and they may not be aware or even able to discern that they are actually deceased. In these situations, there are many angels and guides who try and help them to cross over by helping them to feel the immense light and love of God, and thus increase their light within, making them much lighter. The love and attention that they are given is to help them heal and find peace, and it aids them in releasing the negative grip of the prison of their own making. Once their energies are lifted, they can be clear enough to eventually cross over and review their lives to learn from their past experiences. Yet, the Posse of Angels is reminding us that not all souls get stuck in feeling guilty for what they've done. Some souls see what they've done in taking their life, and they fully accept the consequences that they must now deal with. I found this particularly true in younger souls who were able to sustain pretty high elevated levels of awareness, and they just get on with the task of filling the massive void and vacancies that they left with their decision to exit their life. Now, the Posse of Angels is sharing with us that this is the case, as young people have much less baggage and much less attachment than older people would have had. Now, if you can just imagine that each one of us writes our own contracts and then we act kind of like a master puppeteer as we decide who will our actors be and which strings to pull and when to pull those strings in order to weave and blend various stories into our lives. But now not only do we have to scrap the old scenarios, but new stories have to be put in place with new connections, because we are not there to facilitate them happening. Again, working with the spirit guides of each person in our contract, we need to make 100% sure that those people will still be able to experience and learn their lessons. Once this is all done and seen to completion, then and only then will we have freed our karma that we brought on ourselves through the suicide. Having done this, we are then allowed to be released to review the contract of our lives and our decisions that led us to making such a choice in the first place. Now, the Posse of Angels wishes to remind all of us that suicide is never, ever written into a contract of a life, and it is never the intention of a soul who incarnates into the physical world. We know across the veil that life is so extraordinarily precious, and each incarnation is highly respected for the tremendous life lessons that we teach others and that others will teach us. Now, the Posse of Angels is assuring us that if the person had even the slightest openness to changing their mind about taking their life, that every suicide that ever happened would have been preventable by outside forces occurring, for God and the angels would have staged an intervention. And the Posse of Angels reminds us that there are many times that they send things that interrupt and distract the person from suiciding, but the person is in such a fog that many times they just don't see it. For instance, a bird might have come close to the person or slammed into a window. A person would have been distracted by by somebody turning up unexpectedly. An angel would have taken the guise of, perhaps, a human and interceded in some way. You know, everyone, I once had a client who suffered with profound depression, and he told me that it got so bad he went into a nearby woods intending to take his life. And just as he was about to kill himself, a huge Labrador came bounding out of nowhere and barreled through the woods towards him. My client did not recognize this dog, but the dog leapt upon him, knocked him over, and relentlessly licked his face. As much as he tried to push the dog off of him, the dog sat on him and licked his face. The futility of trying to persuade this dog to let him get on with his task, well, it momentarily diffused his thoughts of suicide. And while his energies calmed down, he sat upright next to a tree, and the dog lay next to him for a very long time. When the thought of suicide had passed, my client got up to go, and the dog got up and ran off in the opposite direction and out of sight. He never did find out where the dog came from, but the posse of angels and I know that it was sent by God. You know, everyone, when a loved one suicides, many family members and friends, they take it upon themselves to think that they somehow failed the person, saying things like, "I should have known and seen this coming. I should have done something." And yet the posse of angels tells us that if you have had a loved one cross over from suicide, that there was literally nothing that you could have done to save them. Knowing that it was the person's free will, and we cannot interfere with free will, there was nothing that they could have done to stop the enormous heavy burden of blaming themselves, it opens up the floodgates for healing and peace to enter one's life. They no longer have to blame themselves, thinking that they could have done something. Now, for those who have had a loved one take their lives, the posse of angels do wish to emphasize that there is no punishment or judgment for this act. And once they have had time, the person who suicides, to view their actions from a heightened perspective, those souls who have taken their life, they often wish to have a second chance. They choose to reincarnate into another human life with comparable lessons that will bring about similar scenarios for the soul, and they are then able to learn from their past experience that is held deep within their subconscious memory. Or, because we have been blessed with free will, perhaps those souls who suicide never wish to reincarnate on earth again. And that's fine too. The important thing to remember is that all life is fraught with challenges, and that you can change your life in any moment, any time you want. The Posse of Angels is reminding us that no matter what has happened, there's always a way out. Not involve exiting life. In fact, they're saying that when one chooses to exit a life, all the lessons that one came back to learn will not go away, but they will be there to be learned in our next incarnation and probably be presented in a much more difficult way for us to acknowledge, process, and to learn from. Now, the Posse of Angels wishes for each one of us to know how cherished and loved each one of us is and how much of a difference we each make on this planet, and that's the reason for you being here. Whatever you're going through, you are certainly not alone, and there are people and organizations to help. And even though God never gives us more than we can handle, many times we do forget how strong we actually are. Please ask for help and be open to accept it in the way that it is given. It may be just as obvious as a big yellow slobbering Labrador appearing out of nowhere to lick your face back to finding your reasons to keep going. Now, the Posse of Angels wishes for us to realize that you're being chosen to inhabit a physical human incarnation at this never experienced time of ascension on our planet is a great honor indeed. Although sometimes it may not seem like it, the Posse of Angels wishes to stress how coveted your time and spot on planet Earth is, and know that there were many, many more souls who wished to be here at the time of ascension, but they were not chosen. You were chosen because your specialized individual energy is such an important part, as are the parts of all the other billions of souls on the planet. And you know, even though there is no judgment and punishment if a soul decides to suicide, it's often a choice that they deeply regret once they see their incarnation from a higher, heightened perspective across the veil in heaven. Now, it's important to remember that when the Posse of Angels use that word heaven, they simply mean a state of mind and not a physical place. In this way, no one can be denied access or stopped from entering heaven. Now, for those who choose to take their own lives, they experience a type of hell, and it has nothing to do with their action of suicide. It has to do with the energy of their perpetuated negative thoughts and emotions that have caused them to take such an action. And rather than all the judgment days that have been depicted throughout the centuries with fire and brimstone, it is we and only we who can either allow our entrance to heaven or prevent it by perpetuating negative emotional energies, experiencing the individual hell that it creates for us. The Posse of Angels wishes to remind all of us that we are human, and as such, there will be times in everyone's life, and I don't care who you are, there will be times in everyone's life when we lose hope. But they are assuring us that the tide always changes. Heartache is a part of human life, and when it takes the sailboat of our lives off course, adrift in a desolate, dark sea, God and the angels will always, always send us a second wind to get us back on course, if we are open to accept the second wind into our sails, so that we can catch our breath and face the world again. You know, everyone, by shining your light of love, kindness, and acceptance as brightly as you possibly can, it just may be our light that illuminates a reason for another soul to stay and continue their incarnation. And when all is said and done, when celebrities choose suicide, who seemingly have all the fame, they have all the money, they have success, or what we've been programmed to believe that success it does shine a spotlight on what it really means to be successful. I love this quote by Ralph Waldo Emerson on what it means to be successful. He says, "To laugh often and much, to win the respect of intelligent people and the affection of children, to earn the appreciation of honest critics and endure the betrayal of false friends, to appreciate beauty and to find the best in others, to leave the world a bit better, whether by a healthy child, a garden patch, or a redeemed social condition, to know that even one life has breathed easier because you have lived. This is what it means to have been successful." And to aid us a little bit further in an additional message to help us get our second wind when despair hits us, I was really not surprised when The animal that came in today was Miss Deer, and she came softly padding in. One of the greatest messages of Deer is to be kind to ourselves. Miss Deer, in her soft, gentle ways and in her nature, reminds us to be calm. It is her quiet tenderness that reflects a grace and suggests that when we approach life, through this way of calm and quiet, then this will activate our life, our light inside, and the faith and hope to steer us through those times when we find ourselves in very dark woods. Deer radiates mother energies of nourishment and nurturing, so we can, what we can do not to lose hope is to be kind to ourselves and to go out in the beautiful, comforting energies of Mother Nature that soothe and heal our energies. By allowing ourselves to just be, we substitute the harmful, damaging thoughts of despair, taking in the energies of a peaceful quiet that will be restorative and help to give us, to get, guide us back to reconnect with our divine eternal natures and the most loving source of all. So thank you, Miss Deer, Miss Deer, for coming in and reminding us to be still, to be quiet, reminding us that those of you that are in despair, the tide always changes. There are people out there and organizations that can provide that help that you need, and that it's in that second wind, allowing that second wind to come into our sails, the tide will change. So thank you, Miss Deer, for coming in. You have been listening to me, Claire Candy Hoff, on Angel Healing House Radio. We are going to take a quick break. If you want to call in for an angel reading, please do call in on 1-800-930-2819 to discuss the topic or perhaps get some of those channeled messages. And we will see you after this short break.
Have you discovered the remarkable books at angelhealinghouse.com? Author Claire Candy Hoff has channeled rare books of inspiration and insight.
Angels of Faith is an inspiring story of healing, comfort, and hope that reminds us that death is not to be feared, but embraced with joy.
One True Home, Behind the Veil of Forgetfulness, takes readers on a roller coaster ride through Angel Ariel's five most important lives on Earth, as well as her experiences in the afterlife, and helps us remember our own journey across the veil.
And Claire Candy's autobiography, I Am an Angelic Walk-In, which details the 2003 soul exchange that took place when Claire Candy walked out of her body and Angel Ariel walked in, creating heaven on earth for herself and others.
To find out more about these wonderful books, visit angelhealinghouse.com today. To see your life from an angel's perspective, book a personal consultation with Claire Candy Hoff, angelic walk-in angel Ariel at Angel Healing House. Candy provides intuitive counseling, Reiki, and angel readings in person in Los Angeles or nationally and internationally via phone or Skype. She will channel the practical tools you need to transform your life. Call now, 831-277-3716, or visit angelhealinghouse.com.
Hello, everyone. You're back with me, Claire Candy Hoff, at this wonderful station, Transformation Talk Radio, on Angel Healing House Radio. Today, we have been speaking about a very timely topic with the death of Kate Spade and also Anthony Bourdain, both of them taking their lives, with our topic entitled Suicide from an Angel's Perspective. So if you want to call in to discuss the topic, or you want to call in to perhaps get some channeled messages from myself and my amazing, wonderful angelic family, the Posse of Angels, do call in on 1-800-930-2819. Let's go to the phone lines to some of those callers. We've got Beth in California. Beth, you're on the line with Angel Healing House Radio.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing very well. I was just thinking about your topic and how it's just so sad because people, when you're the message that the posse is giving you, that people think that when they commit suicide, I think they think that means that all their pain and suffering is over and they can just be done. And then according to what you're saying is, nope, no, no.
No, not done. No. And, you know, besides the fact that, you know, it creates absolute havoc with the contracts that have been put in place. And as I said, all that interweaving and entwining of lives. And you may be the hope for another person, you know, that needs your intervention and calling at the right time or bumping into them or something that gives them the hope to keep going. So I'm just getting shivers all over. So it's enormous when a person chooses to exit their contract early and they just leave so many, it's like leaving all these strings hanging. And all of those things will never happen, but then you make it right from the other side, and you know it's mind-boggling to think how that happens. But then it's mind-boggling to think how contracts are written and formed on the other side, so that each soul will be a compass for somebody, and then another person will be a compass for us to grow and expand and learn our lessons. So it's really unbelievable. But most souls, I must say that most souls, when they cross over, they immediately have this feeling of OMG, what did I do? And this huge stone of regret that they did this.
Well, as you're talking, I'm getting this like message almost like that when you're talking about how we have we're supposed to have, there's stuff that we would have been doing with other people that didn't get done and stuff. It's so sad because of the fact that these people that are celebrities that have supposedly everything that anybody could ever wish for don't want to be on the planet anymore, and I think that maybe their lesson or their gift to us is that we need to pay more attention to mental health.
Yes, that's true. We need,
because people are so embarrassed about that, and so they hide it and they don't want people to know and stuff. And just like they used to with cancer in the 60s or whatever.
It's true.
It's so hard to imagine that all these people who think that they're going to be happier if they have, you know, their career on track or they have this or that, and then these people had that.
Right.
Success. And it's sad.
It is sad. That's why I read that poem or that quote by Ralph Waldo Emerson. You know, what does it mean to be successful? You know, if because of your existence, one person, you know, you made one person smile, you made one person breathe easier, you know, maybe a contribution as, you know, bringing up a healthy, happy, well-adjusted child, you know, you tended a beautiful garden, you know, you contributed to writing a social condition, you know, whatever that is, then you will have succeeded. And it has nothing to do with fame. It has nothing to do with money. It has nothing to do with that being the benchmark of success. And unfortunately, that's what we have been programmed and pushed in our faces by commercialism and commercials and advertising and medium, the media, to say you will be successful if you look a certain way or if you acquire certain material things. So if there is one lesson we can learn from that is that that is not the benchmark of being successful.
Obviously, it doesn't make the person feel any better if they're just going to leave, even though they've accomplished all that.
Exactly. Exactly. So it's a very good mirror for us to really take stock and to think, you know, what does it mean to be successful? What does it mean to be truly at peace?
Yeah, it makes me think, too, because we're all trying to chase some kind of carrot or accomplish something. And when you're reading this and we're talking about it, I'm thinking like it's not even about that.
Exactly. Exactly. Well, studies have shown that it's not even the importance to be happy. It's to provide that meaning for your life, you know, where you feel like you're contributing to the whole. And once you have that, and you bring forth your gifts and your talents, whatever that is, or your abilities, and you are part of something much grander outside of yourself, then you have purpose. Then you have a purpose to get up every single morning, whether you're getting paid for it or not. And that's another default programming that we've conditioned ourselves on the planet, that you don't have any value unless you're being paid for your services.
Yeah.
When in so many different ways, if we really look at our lives, we can be provided for and remunerated in so many ways, and not just monetarily. Or the money can come from other sources. We are limitless, and abundance is our nature. So, it is very sad, but we can look at it again from an angel's perspective, and see what actually has to occur once they do cross over. And it's very important for those who have had family and friends suicide, is to understand that they literally could not have done anything to stop them.
That's an important one right there, because I work with people and they have so much regret.
Yeah.
So much guilt.
Yeah.
That they didn't know and couldn't say. And so to know that it doesn't matter, because that person's already made their decision.
Yes.
And how they've made the decision.
Exactly. And another huge thing is, if you have had somebody suicide, is to understand that there is no judgment on the other side. There's no judgment for whatever you do. I don't care what you've done. When you stand before that loving, wise, etheric counsel on the other side, and you discuss what you've done, I don't care who you are and what you've done, there is absolutely no judgment. There's no judgment at all. There's free will, and that's why we've been given free will, because of the responsibility that we have. And maybe you'll atone for it.
They don't have to come right for it.
Maybe you won't.
Sorry.
Well, I'm sorry, Beth. What was that?
I was going to say, so they don't have to come right back and complete what they didn't complete, then. There's still choice there, even.
Absolutely. Nobody is forced to come back and have another incarnation.
Oh, wow. Okay.
But so then again, you remain at the level. You don't advance in your level of light and in ascension across the veil, unless you do work on those lessons that weren't learned.
Okay, so they still have the work to do. It's just not done. It's just done over there instead of here.
Exactly. You know, they learn their, and a lot of times, and in, especially in my books, One True Home, Behind the Veil of Forgetfulness, and also I'm an Angelic Walk-In, you know, I speak about how souls across the veil, they're very good in learning their lessons in theory, but there's nothing like coming back to the physical fields of matter on the earth plane and learning one's lessons in duality, because then it really sticks. You know, and the practical part of it, then it really is drummed into us.
Oh, okay. So I always thought that if you committed suicide, you had to come right back and do it all over again. So I'm glad to know that there's an option there.
Well, no one is forced to come back. That's one of the blessings and also the curses of free will. You know, no one is forced to come back. I know of many souls who chose to experience a physical incarnation one time, and that was it. It was too hard for them.
Yeah.
Now, because there's no time across the veil, you know, they could say it one day that they're not going to come back in a physical incarnation, and then time passes, which is a time of no time, and then they could decide further down the track that they do want to come back. So, no, nobody forces another soul to come back.
Okay, good. There's no requirement.
No, there's no requirements. There's just the requirement to be. So, did you have a question today, or is it just a general cards?
Just a general reading would be great.
Okay,
because of the full moon coming in and stuff.
Yeah, wonderful full moon coming in. And that's preparing us, like I said, for us to release and surrender anything that we have felt that is perhaps blocking us or we're sabotaging ourselves, because what's coming
that's
in
what
July.
I'd like to know.
Yeah.
That's what's what I would like to know. Is there anything? What's blocking me? Is there anything left that I need to look at?
Okay, let's have a look. Two of Pentacles. This is the card of, a lot of times it's the Pentacles are the cards of abundance, of money. They want you to not worry so much about finances, about feeling guilty about spending this and spending that. The universe knows that you're not a spendthrift, but they want you to be mindful. They want you to be mindful about not worrying about this. You know, when you they're saying that's your default, but when you go to that, always then immediately say, I'm always provided for in the most divine, perfect ways, and I will always be taken care of because I'm a child of God. And once you say that, then all the worry seems to dissipate. Okay?
Perfect.
Okay, so that's a really good one. Next, let's see what comes into... I love this. Okay. This is the Trust card, the Eight of Swords. The woman is bound, but her hands are not tied. Her feet are not tied. She could get out of the situations. This is always the Trust the Universe card. Stop trying to figure it out. They're saying your mind needs to relax. Your mind needs to slow down and to stop being so busy in trying to figure out how this is all going to come about. Okay. And when you find yourself doing this, make a concerted effort to just go out in nature, ask for nature to show you, just like the beautiful deer that came in as an animal, how to calm down, how to be peaceful. Nature accepts, and they want you to accept too. I guess that's the what they're saying is practice the art of allowance. And then the next card the next card for you is the King of Pentacles. And the King of Pentacles is that card that there is the material and the manifestation of the material in your life. This is not going to stop. You're in the flow. This is going to continue. Yeah. And to put your emphasis yeah. on that rather than, you know, thinking that it's going to stop at some stage, or that you have to figure out how to keep this going, because the universe is, and God and the angels, and you are co-creating this beautiful, abundant life. So I hope that's been helpful.
Yes, it was wonderful. Thank you so much. And I'm really grateful that you were talking about this subject, because it needs to be discussed. And I'm so glad you were able to touch on that.
Thank you so much, Beth. Have a beautiful day. Sending lots of love.
You too, Angel. You
Bye-bye.
Too, Angel. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Beth, for calling in. Let's go to our next caller. We have Stephanie in New York. Stephanie, you're online with Claire Candy Hoff. How are you today?
Hi. I'm good. Thank you. I thought, I'm glad. I was hoping, I think, last week that you were going to talk about the suicide, so I'm glad that you brought it up this week.
Yes, very important subject.
Yeah, and I was actually surprised that I was so affected by Anthony Bourdain's death, because, you know, I have his book, but I never read it, and I don't have cable, so I wasn't watching, you know, the show or anything.
Right.
But I almost met him a year ago, because he's friends with an acquaintance of mine from
right.
Massachusetts,
mm-hmm.
and there was an event I was invited to, and I didn't go, because I was embarrassed that I've gained all this weight since I've been in New York.
Oh.
And that I wasn't working, so I didn't go. But when I saw pictures afterward, I remember looking at him and feeling his sadness and being confused by it and surprised by it. And I kept thinking about that when I heard that he died. And then I do this horrible thing where I'm like, maybe I could have helped him, or I could have said something, or, you know,
yeah.
which I probably wouldn't have. But it made it so much harder, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
That we almost crossed paths, and that I saw his pain.
Wow. It's really important for everyone to understand that if you've known somebody or an acquaintance or a loved one or whatever, there was literally nothing that you could have done because of their free will. And it takes the burden of blame off of that person. And to know that there is no judgment on the other side. So these things can really help someone in this case.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And I thought, thank you. And I had this experience in my 20s where I had sort of like this experience, it felt like, of me sort of coming into this life. And it was sort of like what you were talking about with the suicide people, where I was like thinking I made a mistake and was like feeling like a second guessing as I was sort of coming through. And I've had all these health challenges. You know, they think I have maybe a uterine cancer now, which is really scary, and things are getting worse and worse with my uterus, and now there's a polyp. And, you know, I've wondered if there's some part of me that, like some subconscious part of me that just wants to go, because it's so strange that I keep getting sick, and it's also very scary, and I don't want to go and even get the biopsy. Like the whole thing with the hospital and all of that just feels so scary, or not like really what I want to do. I just want to be healthy. But
let's go to the cards and see if there's anything that's stopping you. And what you possibly could surrender with this new full moon coming on Thursday. So the first card for you is the Strength card. The health challenges many times that we choose are to just show us how strong we are, and you know, for us to dig deep, to find that strength inside of ourselves to keep going. The posse of angels are saying, please do not delay in getting something like a biopsy or things like that, you know, because it's better to know. It's better to know what you're dealing with rather than, you know, than putting it off. So you've got the strength card. The strength card is also reminding you, Stephanie, that you are strong enough. And that, you know, as I said in today's channel, many times we forget how really strong we are. The next card is the Nine of Swords. This is the worry card. This is the card that's like us gnashing our teeth at night, and our mind can't stop, and about putting our emphasis on what is going wrong rather than seeing that as some kind of a warning or a symptom for us to say the body at some stage, the energies in the body would have been depleted, the immune system went down, and then the dis-ease in the body shows up. So it's to restore the and exchange that worry for the positive energies of thanking that you have access to doctors, you have access to all those different things, and the way you eat, the way you think, all of those things. So watch the worry in your life and those energies that you're giving that. And the next card that will come out is the Ace of Wands. And this is a beginning. This is a new beginning. So what I would actually do with this full moon is I would do a surrendering. I would do a ritual around surrendering and saying, I release anything that is stopping me from being as healthy as I possibly can. See yourself well and thank, you know, thank the medical community, thank those around you that you have access to, and change that worry to strength and for those positive energies to balance out the worry that you have. So I hope that's been helpful for you.
Yeah, it has. But it's, you know, the where she wants to do it is at the hospital where I had my ovarian cancer surgery, mm-hmm. which was very traumatic.
Right.
And it's also scary to go under anesthesia again. And I'm just worried that something would even go wrong, even if it's not a cancer, although, they seem to think it is. But just that
and that's why the,
something
that,
would go wrong there.
And that's why that worry card came up. That it's perfectly human and natural to be concerned and to have those thoughts, but always change them, always preface them by saying, you know, I am looked after. I am looked after. I am protected. And I see myself as well. And because that worry can affect your health, and it affects our health in such a detrimental way. So I'm sending you lots of healing energies, and I'm sending you lots of love. I've got to go now. And
thank you.
See yourself in that beautiful light, Stephanie. Take care of yourself.
Okay.
Okay, bye-bye. And that just about wraps the show up for today. Thank you to my callers. Thank you to everyone who is listening to the show. Please remember that Angel Healing House Radio airs every week on Tuesdays at 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And if you'd like to find out more about my amazing books, The Remarkable Angels of Faith, based on my two near-death experiences, One True Home, Behind the Veil of Forgetfulness, about my five most important past lives, and the lives in between those lives. What the heck did I do between those lives in heaven? And the next one is my autobiography. It's actually the sequel to One True Home, Behind the Veil of Forgetfulness, is I Am an Angelic Walk-In, which tells the amazing story, true story, about how the former soul that was in this body walked out in January 11th of 2003, and I, Angel Arielle, walked in to clean up her life, take over her responsibilities, create heaven on earth for myself, and then created heaven on earth helped others to create heaven on earth for themselves. You can find out all about these books on my website, which is angelhealinghouse.com. Remember, everyone, this coming week, go out and fashion an absolutely beautiful life for yourself. Nobody is going to do this for you. You're a success because you are you. And you have so much to offer by just being you. Nobody can fashion that beautiful life for yourself. You do it by being yourself and sharing yourself with the planet. So I'm wishing you love and, as always, angel blessings. And I look forward to speaking with you again next week. Take care, everyone. Bye.